हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रंस। टुडे थर्सडे 2nd जुलाई। नाउ लेट वन ऑफ ब्रेंडजेस प्रॉफिट लॉस एंड डिस्काउंट। क्वेश्चन 4th, हाउ मच परसेंट अबव द कॉस्ट प्राइस, हाउ मच परसेंट अबव द कॉस्ट प्राइस शुड ए शॉपकीपर मार्क हिज गुड्स so that after allowing a discount of 20% on the mark price, he gains 12%. How much percent above the cost price should a shopkeeper mark his goods so that after allowing a discount of 20%, discount 20% is given on the mark price, he gains 12%. So first of all, let we take mark price of goods be rupees 100, discount is given, let not mark price, he gains 12%. Let cost price of goods be rupees 100, gains 12%. So selling price of goods is equal to CP into 100 plus gain percent upon 100. 100 into 100 plus 12 upon 100 is equal to 112. So selling price is your 112. Now after that, discount is 20%. So mark price, selling price rupees 112, discount 20%. Mark price of goods is equal to SP into 100 upon 100 minus discount percent. 112 into 100 upon 100 minus 20, 80, 0, 14, 8 ones are 14, 10 are 140. So your question is that how much percent above the cost price? We have to find the rate of amount above the cost price. So first find amount above the cost price. Mark price of goods is rupees 140 and cost price of the goods rupees 100. So amount above the cost price is equal to rupees 140 minus 1 rupees 40. Now percentage above the cost price is equal to 40 upon 100 into 100, 40%. So in this way we can solve this sum. Next, I go for a fifth sum. Rohit marks his goods at 40% above the cost price. Rohit marks mean marked price of the goods 40% above. Let the cost price of the goods be rupees 100, then your mark price will be 40% above the cost price, means rupees 100 plus 40% of rupees 100, rupees 100 plus 40 is equal to rupees 140. But allows a discount of 5% for each payment to his customer. What actual profit does he make? What actual profit? So you have to find actual profit he made. If he receives means if the selling price, one of the selling price is given 1064, you have to find other selling price. Okay. Now let cost price of the goods be rupees 100. Mark price of goods rupees 100 plus 40% of rupees 100 is equal to rupees 100 plus 40 is equal to rupees 140. Discount 5%. Selling price is equal to mark price into 100 minus discount percent upon 100. 140 into 100 minus 5, 95 upon 100. It is equal to rupees 133. Now, your selling price is rupees 133 and cost price is your rupees 100. So from here you can find profit, because SP is greater than CP. Profit is equal to rupees 133 minus 100 is equal to 33. Now if selling price of goods is rupees 133, then profit earned is equal to 33. If selling price of goods is rupees 1, then profit received is equal to rupees 33 upon 133. Or if selling price of goods, it is given in your question 1064, then profit earned is equal to rupees 33 upon 138 into 133 into 1064. So this is 133 1 jar 8, 33 into 8 is equal to rupees 264. So thus actual profit he make is equal to rupees 264 answers. Now next, sixth and last question of this worksheet. This will be your homework, because listen here, Mr. Kumar went to shopping with his family to a mall. Mrs. Kumar bought a saree for rupees 12,500, clothes for kids for rupees 9,280, and shirts for Mr. Kumar is rupees 10,445. If the GST charge on the purchases is 12%, then what is the total amount that Mr. Kumar has paid? Now, Mr. Kumar went to shopping with his family, and Mrs. Kumar bought a saree for rupees 12,500, cloth for kids rupees 9,280, and shirts for Mr. Kumar rupees 10,445. First of all, you have to find the total amounts spent on all articles. 12,500 plus 9,280 plus 10,445. After that, GST percent is given 12%. So find GST amount for GST. This is equal to 12% upon 100 into total cost price, and this amount should be added to this cost price. So that amount Mr. Kumar has to paid. Okay, so try to solve this sum. I go for horse question. This is the mark price of an article is rupees 3,500 and rate of GST. Mark price is given, rate of GST is given. Find selling price. So this will be 3,500 plus 12% of 3,500. Shopkeeper allows a discount of 20%. After that, 20% discount is given. So find selling price after discount. First find selling price, because mark price is given, GST is given. Find selling price. After that, find selling price after discount. 20% is given. Then find selling price after discount. After that, profit is given 10%. So we have to find cost price. So find the original cost price of the article and the selling price including GST. Look here, mark price of an article is rupees 3,500, GST 12% amount for GST, 12% of rupees 3,500, 12 upon 100 into 3,500, rupees 420. Selling price of an article is equal to rupees 3,500 plus 420, rupees 3,920, or discount of 20%. Then selling price after discount is equal to 3,920 minus 20% of 3,900. It is equal to 3,136. Okay. Now, profit percent is given. Cost price of an article is equal to, this is your cost price, 3,136. Now, cost price of an article is equal to SP into 100 upon 100 plus profit percent, 3,136 into 100 upon 110, 00, 31,360 upon 11. Rupees 2850.90. After that, we have to find the cost price of article and selling price after including GST. GST 12%, CP including GST is equal to rupees 2850. Now this will be your answer. One is your CP, other one is your SP. Now after that, you have to find CP including GST. Rupees 2850 plus 0.90 plus 12% of 2850.90, it is equal to 3,193. Okay, this will be your end of this chapter, profit loss and discount. tomorrow I start your new chapter, that is introduction to graph. So get it, graph from market, and this only not so lengthy chapters of introduction to graph. It has only introductions to graph. Your chapter is thirteenth, introduction to graph. Introduction of this graph, Cartesian plane, then plotting a points on graph, and construction of graph. Only two worksheet are there. So before 10th of July we have to complete these chapters. So please, you have to get graph notebook from market. So tomorrow we start new chapter, that is introduction to graph. Thank you. Have a nice day.